Hi guys, it is a spectacularly gorgeous day here on the rock. I had a few technical difficulties, so here I am back again doing my real rant of the day today. Friday, January 18th, 2013. I guess this means we're a couple of days away for the return of King Barack Obama coming in for another 4 years of filling the blank. This blank is going to be filled in talking about Barack Obama's absolute joke of a U.S. energy policy. We got 4 more years to look forward to. It's starting, when is Inauguration Day? Is it a couple of days? And I guess this year, they've pulled all pretense off. Barack Obama has just invited any giant multinational corporation that wants to throw him some money, to throw a party, to come on in. So no doubt, taking his invitation will be the giant energy corporations, particularly the fossil fuel industry, will be throwing a party for their one of their chief puppets on this planet, Barack Obama, in a couple of days, and Obama can charge ahead with 4 more years of developing this country's energy policy. But apparently, he's going to be throwing kind of a party by himself, because reading the mainstream media, it looks like every damn person connected with anything to do with the environment or energy policy in the Obama cabinet is fleeing out of complete embarrassment. So anyway, this rant comes to me directly from the mainstream media today for a very well-written analysis here in the Associated Press. Can't get more mainstream media than this, and I will just read this article and make some comments along the way. I will put a link to it. I encourage you to go read this for yourself. The headline of this AP article is "Obama to confront oil pipeline and climate change." Okay, there's going to be a confrontation between Barack Obama and the oil pipeline and climate change. And before I launch into this article, let me put on my doomsday prophet hat here and make a couple of predictions. I don't even have to look over the next 4 years. I just need to look into the next few weeks that you will see Barack Obama, the planet-saving Sierra Club Messiah, King Barack Obama, in the next few weeks will okay the Keystone XL pipeline so we can move all of this toxic sludge, all of this planet-eating toxic sludge from Canada all the way across the U.S., and we'll probably send about 2/3 of it over to China, so they can burn it. So that will be the first order of the day of Barack Obama's new lonely energy policy. Climate change. Okay, I'm just going to do a doomsday prophet prediction over the next 4 years about how Barack Obama is going to, is this going to be a repeat of the last 4 years? Barack Obama is going to completely ignore the single biggest threat, hands down, bar none, to every American in this country and every person on this planet, which is climate change, global warming, human-induced climate change caused by the burning of fossil fuels. In response to this, Barack Obama will ramp up the production of fossil fuels all across this country. There's a small possibility that coal mining will be scaled back a tiny bit. Gas fracking. Obama acts like he invented gas fracking, for God's sake. I do not agree with the pundits who say the gas fracking bubble is ready to burst. It's ready to explode, but it's not ready to burst. And let's not forget my favorites of all, the oil companies. Big oil will be pumping out with each succeeding year. The good old U.S. of America, with Barack Obama at the helm, will ramp up its production of fossil fuels. Now, there might be a reduction in the burning of the production of greenhouse gases in this country over the next 4 years. You might see this, but make sure you understand that it's going to be more than compensated by the rise of greenhouse gases over there in China, coming from fossil fuels produced here in the United States and sold to China. Anyway, this is just the Hambun Little Tail roundup of predictions for how Barack Obama is going to handle the energy crisis. Let me go, and I'm just, as I say, I'm putting a link to this article, but I'm going to go down and read some of it and make some comments for anybody who cannot read for themselves. Can listen to me do this, or you can read it yourself. Okay, excellent article. President Barack Obama's second-term energy agenda is taking shape, and despite the departure of key cabinet officials, it looks a lot like the first one. More reliance on renewable energy sources such as wind and solar, and expanded production of oil and natural gas. Even the mainstream media understands this as well as Hambun and Littledale. Obama also is promising, one more promise, Obama also is promising to address climate change, an issue he has acknowledged was sometimes overlooked during his first term. Well, thank you for the acknowledgement, Mr. Crow-Eating Obama, that climate change, the single biggest threat to this country, a hell of a lot bigger than any threat posed by any threats to our energy security, it has not been overlooked. It has been completely absent. Completely absent. Leader of the free world, my ass, the puppet of the oil company. Here's a fellow, Clark Stevens, White House spokesman Clark Stevens, quote, "The president has been clear that tackling climate change and enhancing energy security will be among his top priorities in his second term." Well, guys, we already have a red flag flapping at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. This is a contradiction in terms. Tackling climate change while at the same time enhancing energy security. Since the definition of enhancing energy security is ramping up the production of the fossil fuels that cause climate change. So let's explode that myth, that you can't do that. Okay, while the administration, this is according to this Clark Stevens dude, while the administration has made progress in developing renewable energy and improving fuel efficiency standards for vehicles, quote, "we know there is more work to do." And then it goes from there, and I agree with him. I like this guy, this reporter, I think it's Matthew Daly. But Obama will have to do that work with new heads of the agencies responsible for the environment, because it sounds like every damn person on any level in the Obama administration that has any interest in the environment of this country, particularly this country's pathetic response to climate change, is fleeing in absolute embarrassment and humiliation, no doubt. So just to let it be known that they have nothing to do with Obama rubber stamping this Keystone oil pipeline. They want to be gone so they don't get accused of it. Let's hear some of the people who are splitting. Interior Secretary Ken Salazar, he's out the door. And they're leaving. They're not being fired. They are running. Interior Secretary Ken Salazar, EPA Chief Lisa Jackson, National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration Chief Jane Lubchenco, they've all said, we're out of here. And Energy Secretary Stephen Chu himself is expected to follow his colleagues out the door in coming weeks. So the White House says no decisions have been made on replacements for any of these guys. So anyway, they talk about all the various and people up for those positions. All right, let's talk about this Keystone Pipeline. One of the first challenges Obama will face is an old problem, whether to approve the Keystone XL oil pipeline from Canada to Texas. He blocked the pipeline last year, citing uncertainty over its route through environmentally sensitive land in Nebraska. Well, guess what? They've now come up with a new route, which, as I predict, Barack Obama, dancing to the strings of big oil, that, you know, the oil company's paying for his inauguration party in a couple of days. He will rubber stamp that, and they will get this toxic sludge flowing. Okay. Environmental groups have urged Obama to block the pipeline, which they say would transport dirty oil from tar sands in western Canada and produce heat-trapping gases that contribute to global warming. If the pipeline is approved, quote, the Obama administration would be actively supporting, I would say will be actively supporting and encouraging the growth of an industry which has demonstrably serious effects on climate. 18 top climate scientists wrote in a letter to Obama this week. Okay. So that's number one. While he's rubber stamping that project, that's against the bigger backdrop of Obama faces a choice over whether to promote a boom in oil and natural gas production. That should read to continue to promote a boom in oil and natural gas production that has in fact hampered growth of energy sources such as wind and solar. And so now they start talking about fracking, which has been mostly gas fracking, but it's getting more and more into oil fracking. The emergence of cheap, plentiful natural gas in particular poses a dilemma for Obama, who supports gas development as a cleaner alternative to fossil fuels that trigger global warming. Newsflash, Barack Obama. Natural gas is a fossil fuel that triggers global warming. Natural gas and its attendant little bogeyman, methane, which is produced in the production of natural gas. Jesus, many environmental groups who otherwise support the president, they're probably referring to the Sierra Club, you know, who thinks that, you know, who has proclaimed Barack Obama to be their messiah. many environmental groups who support the president are wary of natural gas and are critical of drilling techniques such as fracking, which allows drillers to gain access to reserves that formerly were out of reach. Environmental groups are pushing the administration to do more to crack down on fracking. Okay, so anyway, they talk about this, guys, but the gas fracking boom, as I said a minute ago, is going to continue to ramp up in this country, but more than that, you better believe the oil fracking, this shale gas, which is fracking and its closer cousins, they're all birds of a feather. And you better believe that as this fracking cranks up, where is it going to be cranking up? It's going to be cranking up on the 800 million acres of America's public lands that Barack Obama has handed over to big oil to take their drilling rigs onto our public lands to ramp up the production of this as he dances to the puppet strings of big oil. Oh boy, the only possible light in the tunnel here is he might start trimming back on coal-fired power plants, at least here in this country. But you better believe for every coal-fired power plant that we switch over to natural gas in this country, that's just that much more of this mountaintop removal coal that they can load onto these barges and ship off to China, so China can burn America's coal in the 455 new coal-powered power plants scheduled to open in China. And then, interestingly enough, they start talking about, after they finish talking about the coal-fired power plants, I guess I should have left them my comments about these public lands, because environmental groups also hope Obama will use his executive authority to protect more wild places. Oh boy, we're hoping Obama can leave a legacy for the conservation of public lands and have a real vision for it, said Jamie Williams, president of the Wilderness Society. As I said, guys, Obama's legacy, his legacy as far as public lands in the United States are concerned, is that he is going to hand over 800 million acres of public lands to be raped and pillaged by the fossil fuel industry. Then I love it. Here is Michael Brune, executive director of the Sierra Club. You know, I've already had my rants about the Sierra Club's just downright pathetic, embarrassing worship of Barack Obama. So let's see what the executive director of the Sierra Club, Michael Brune, has to say. He says Obama's second term will be pivotal in the fight against climate change, which Brune called the, quote, singular issue of our time for anyone who cares about clean air, clean water, and a safe future for our families. Brune urged Obama to take, quote, swift, decisive action to prevent more erratic weather, superstorms, and wildfires. Good luck, Michael. Trying to convince your messiah, Barack Obama, to pay one bit of attention to any of this. It is going to be business as usual for the next 4 years. It's 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. It is going to be a repeat of the last 4 years. And if anything, it is going to be an acceleration of it. Obama will do some unbelievably horse shit, lying sack of shit lip service about what he is doing to combat climate change. That shit will be pouring out of that guy's mouth, that lying sack of shit's mouth, while with his robo pen, he will be signing off millions of acres of our public lands, ramping up fracking, approving pipelines, handing over Alaska, handing over the Arctic Ocean to all of these guys with their hands out in Washington that will be cheering him on at his inauguration parade in a couple of days. Since they're the ones who paid for it, I guess they should get to enjoy it. And with that, maybe the universe will actually let me get this one uploaded without spitting me off my computer. Bye, guys.